Alright, so we are back and we're going to continue on. Well, from now we're going to do Shadows from the Star. Actually, wait, I thought I saw something. Let me switch back because I saw something there. It said something about playing first. Okay, so hold on. Okay, so I gotta wait a moment for the scrolling text at the bottom of the ship. Because I am not sure what it said something about playing Tower of Doom first. Oh, okay, that's what it meant. Yeah, Shadow Mastara wasn't all that complex, I think. I do remember Shadow Mastara being much more hilarious if you were spamming the shell lightning bolt. Like, I remember lightning bolt being extremely strong there. But it has been a long time. There's a lot of challenges here. I think this time we'll play the dwarf. So here you got more characters to pick from. Now, remember correctly, some are technically, you know, palette swaps, like the elf, same as the magic user. You got the thief, which is same as the, actually, sure. Yeah, we'll play dwarf. As you can see here, massive upgrades. Whoa! Oh, hang on, I need to change the controls, because I cannot play like that. Let's see. Oh, okay. Oh, yep, it is alright. Alright, so we're good. Never mind. I was just brain farting. Now we have more classic D&D enemies like the goblins. Honestly, this, yeah, that dwarf is like straight fucking Unga Bunga. That's a better way of doing it than the other one. Well, keep thinking. Oh, this one actually put our entire name in this time. Yeah, that's pretty badass. Wait, yeah, Gauntlet's a power of what? Surprise. Nobody told me that. What is he saying? Alright, that's pretty fucking badass. Gotta have to remember that one. Oh, you green goblin looking son of a bitch. Mega Man slide? What the hell was that? There's so much about this game I don't remember. Okay, that was great! Dwarf has a fucking Unga Bunga war cry! I love it!
You changed your luck too, what?
Goblins for you. Guess it. Ooh. Yep. So that's goblins for you, just as stupid as orcs in 40k, but half the size. Fight! A juggernaut, huh? Alright, let's go. Okay, hellhounds. These guys are ultra annoying than the previous one. Here to kind of chumps. Hmm. Oh, fuck. Wrong button. Hell of a lot here. Whoa! Badass. What was that? It sped up all randomly. Holy shit! What the hell is that thing? And unlike the first one, you can change your character when you die. And you keep the XP too. There we go. Don't mind me, just taking your stuff.
Welcome.
All right, let's go. All right, so Shadow Elves are back around. Oh, great, dragons. Shadow off my ass. Come on, just call them drow. They are. Guess we don't have a key. Yeah. me up here, huh? Oh, good, there's burn you anymore if you throw it. That's a huge upgrade. Oh, we walk in front of it now. That makes sense. Okay, we almost got him. Ooh. Down. Oh, that familiar music. It looks like the same, that weird high-pitched jackass from the first one. So he's got a name now. And he puts a bass in his voice now. Pretty sure it's that lightning bolt ring right by now. Also, holy shit, that after image shit is pretty cool. I think he actually takes damage from that from that when you respawn like that. Okay, what the fuck? Oh. Right. So is this evil twin, or is he the good? Is this the good twin? What the fuck was that? I'm actually really confused. Cool. Index 04. So we have airships in a D&D game. You sure we're not Final Fantasy right about now? This is a forest? What the hell? Oh, fuck me. Fucking beholder. These guys are bad fucking news. Usually they're not meant to be fought by a party in, you know, standard D&D, and they have instant death attacks. They actually severed some of his eye stalks, okay. Oh my god, what? This is a teen rated game? That is one revealing outfit. Okay, so we need. I think we'll hold on to our stuff for now. What the hell is that? A tree? Manticore again. Oh, this is cheap. Hmm.
That should hit him. So mostly level funky again. Okay. Oh, we can move ahead. Oh, we can ignore them. Alright, cool. Why fight? We don't have to. Oh boy. Yep, of course it'll tell us that right before we fight some. Doesn't seem like I can actually use that, okay. So where the hell are we? Hey, I know, damn fairy, quit doing that. I'm not supposed to go that way. Well, guess we can't take everything. What kind of weak-ass adventures are we if we can't take everything with us? Oh, shit. Oh, fuck me, Carcass is back. He's pissed off. Oh, hey, we got an achievement. Gold digger. I think it's probably just for opening chests, I think. Arch mod.
More of a threat than Dangless was. The figure. There we go, chump. Experience my ass. All right. One way to clean the room out. There's a piece ahead using the illusion. Oh, hey, we've got two more achievements. Get stronger and apprentice. Huh. Running achievements in here. Lot here. Oh, holy shit! Alright, so this is the place to be. This place to be again. Got another achievement, Stomptastic. I'm not sure what it is. Sorry for, knocking down, attacking downed enemies, rather. Yeah. Ah, I love that AoE damage. It helps clean out a room. Really help. It's really useful. I love it. Running up Splicer Beast is this? There we go. Man, that looks weird. Things to strip freebasing steroids. What the hell was that? Holy shit, that thing is tiny. Those are not gnomes! Okay, I've got a comment about this. This is bizarre, even by D&D standards, because gnomes are not that small, like, at all. They're more like halfling-sized, and halflings are around 3 feet. And dwarves are 4 to 4.5, if I remember right, for tallest. So this is actually bizarre, even by D&D standards. Ooh. Take a nose. Nice stuff here. There we go. Yeah, probably you said better. Yeah. Insta-broken. Special attacks that you can use. Huh. Guess not. I thought there was like a special move that they use, a thing just magic user did. I'm trying to figure out why these things can fly. I think that they're not actually supposed to be able to. I'll get leveled up in... Okay, interesting. So you're not stuck with just one. Interesting. Try switching to him. Yeah, he's a... Holy shit, Vhagar! Aha! Okay, that's pretty badass. Oh, that's metal! Like just jumping in the air and release a giant powder. Fuck you. Badass. Oh, it changes our name. Well, okay. Re-input. Whoop. Doesn't look like it resets our XP. Yeah, it does not reset our golden XP either. That's good. Say it's locked, but you see that it's got an open door. Welcome. Cave, huh? Badass. Dirty below? Whoa, boy, that's not good. 40, 50. Wonder if we're supposed to climb out of one of these. 80. How deep is this cave? Oh, I don't think. Let's see. Oh. Alright. Too frozen world. Lost world. Go see dinosaurs down here?
You?
Huh. Alright, there we go. Mess around him for a bit. Oh, cool. Don't even go to melee range. Nice. Badass! I think the magic works better when you have a partner, because you can freeze them and they can just jump on them. Oh, it's limited ammo, interesting. Hell hit me. Okay, so I think with the magic use here, you have to actually do combos in it. Okay, that's not it. Cancel. So with the magic user, I think you have to actually use those button combos in order to do spells. Let me see if I can look that up real quick. Okay, I'm not actually sure how to calculate the cast these, so could be. So I'm not actually sure. So it does not seem to say, it may just be item based. A frost zone, what the fuck? Okay, I wasn't expecting that. Okay, so you can dash around. Interesting. Alright, back to the dwarf. I have no idea how to use the magic spells properly. Whatever the hell this thing is. I heard a frost one. So I remember it's supposed to be, you know, fire only. These things really are fucking mean though, so. Alright. Art spot. Got to use the, this over and over.
Art Bond.
Why is this guy that weird community?
Art Bond. Art Bond. Art Bond. Art Bond.
Stubborn. Now I get it done. Come here, you little bastard. Holy shit. I can't get near him. Yeah, that's happening now, buddy. That's not taking like a man. Air Castle, fuck me. We've gone full Fantasy Star in here. Useful. Great thief my ass. Where the hell was she during all that? We got kind of a puzzle here. Drop so fast, damn. I can jump around and attack from the sky too, buddy. I'm not impressed. Here we go.
Art
I think I would just maintain distance from him like that. Doing that crazy lightning stuff. He seems way less spammy of his annoying abilities from the first one. Down you go. Nothing bonus. This again. Get out of my way. Ignore him and go on. Oh, this is not good. Surprisingly easy. Oh, crap. I wanted to keep that lightning bolt ring. Oh, well. Hey, we could sell that, huh? Battle Royal, okay. Bring him on. That's a battle royal, almost like a Royal Rumble here. Gotta kill him. What the hell is that? Okay, that's pretty cool. Just jumps up and rotates it in the air. Okay, I can say a hit button. Now that's badass. Let me dash in that area. Odd.
Arc spawn. Arc spawn.
Okay, just ignore them. Yeah, here we go again. Oh, fuck me. Gotta look at my spitter like the Aatrox now. Now we got Zuck Bar exposed.
Arc spawn.
There we go. Nice. Let's go. How many arenas are in this one? This owl thing is just annoying, huh? Fry, bastard, fry! Oh, we got a cheater. Hold on, let me see what that says. Oh, we got completed all three tiers of a challenge called So Desperate. What? Let's look at this after we get this through. I don't know what the hell that is. This is pretty funny to say you're right doing this over and over. Experience my ass. Which is through all your buddies, Budget LeBlanc. Oh shit! Okay, so she could do that. So, I guess if you don't fight, this makes me fight a red dragon as a boss, even if you ignore the one in the Tower of Doom. Oh, it's a desperation attack, I think. So I'm taking damage from using it. Oh shit! Got a new trick.
Arcbond.
Oh, now we got a life bar down. Oh, fuck me. Ooh, she's tough. Oh, she can still see you. Okay, then. That's about all right, honestly, because, you know, Dragon's... Green Shack. Yeah, this is one of the better boss fights. But you can just cheese it by, you know, using the Zerg Rush tactic. Straight up Unga Bunga. Vibes, huh?
Oh, shit.
We got an achievement for clearing this. Convenient. Nothing a lot of firepower can't solve, I guess. I guess there's different endings depending on which one you clear it with. We have different texts. Something I like is that how each of them have palette swaps. Reading chat, the new .emo TMT. I don't know. I'll give it a try, possibly. So let's look at those challenges. Oh, that's probably what that thing was early on, that's Ifrit-like summon. So let's look at that challenge thing. Oh wow, two more we would have gotten that. Oh wow, 50, okay. We were just spamming the shit out of that. Down up technique. See, a lot of these there doesn't seem to actually be any knowledge of how to do. Oh yeah, now they're calling him Drow Elf. You know, Drow instead of, you know, Shadow. What the hell is that? Wouldn't be D&D if it wasn't inconsistent. There's a lot of interesting stuff here to grab. Let's see what... I'm really curious to know about where the house rules thing is, so I'm gonna look that up. Oh, you had to unlock it by the points, okay. So, go ahead and unlock this. Ah, yep, this is where you unlock them. So they have different ones, okay. Oh, that's pretty cool. So it seems like Hedgehog combined with Make It Rain, which makes things very interesting. Alright, so, that's it for this stretch of Capcom month. Next time I have to decide what's next, but it won't be that long from now. Thanks for watching.